Hi, and welcome to Four Paws Explains, an educational series where we at the global animal welfare organization Four Paws focus on specific topics related to animal welfare. My name is Nina Jamal, and in this video, I'll explain why zoonoses are on the rise and should be taken more seriously. Zoonotic diseases are nothing new. They've always existed. But the way we treat animals and our environment has dramatically increased the number and severity of zoonotic disease outbreaks and pandemics. Human-driven climate change, ecosystem destruction, biodiversity loss, intensive farming, and the exploitation of wildlife have all created ideal conditions for zoonotic diseases to emerge, mutate, and spread across the globe faster than ever before. But how exactly do these factors trigger disease outbreaks? Before we answer this question, don't forget to subscribe to never miss an episode of Four Paws Explains. Our increased appetite for animal products has an immense impact on the environment. Animals need a lot of food. To produce this food, we need agricultural land, which is gained by cutting down trees and converting forests. This drives deforestation and climate change. So to grow food for all the animals in factory farms, we're disrupting the boundaries between wilderness and human-inhabited land. The boundaries between ecosystems inhabited by humans on the one hand and by wild animals on the other are called ecotones. Here, at the ecotones, zoonotic diseases thrive, mutate, and jump to humans. Deforestation expands the ecotones, enlarging the areas where humans come into contact with wild animals and their infections. As a result, we're not only taking away wild animals' habitats, but also jeopardizing the natural processes that have up to now protected humans from zoonotic diseases. When animals lose their homes because of deforestation, the stress makes them more prone to illness, which is then passed on to humans. This is how wildlife exploitation and habitat loss fuel pandemic risks. So we've established that as we lose biodiversity, zoonotic diseases emerge faster and faster. At the same time, global warming allows mosquitoes to transmit diseases further into areas that were too cold for them to survive in the past. As you can see, it is all interlinked. The relationship between humans, animals, and the environment affect disease risks. In the end, when they suffer, we suffer. However, when we treat animals better and our environment better, we are in fact also protecting human health. That's all for today at Four Paws Explains. Join us next time to find out more about how improving animal welfare helps prevent zoonotic disease outbreaks and pandemics.